Dear student, myself Rajendra Asiri. I am assistant professor in computer science department at Government Bangad PG College, Didwana. In the previous lecture, we discussed various concepts on database and management system. We discussed about various users in database and management system architecture and various levels of abstraction like physical, logical and view level already we have discussed and their importance. Okay, then we have started in query language. In query language, we discussed about procedural and non-procedural query language. We discussed some concept about SQL and practiced many query on the SQL concept. Then we started about relational algebra and domain relational and tuple relational calculus. Then some very important topic about safety of expression in tuple relational calculus and domain relational calculus we have discussed. Now in today's lecture, we are starting about a design process of a database, modeling various type of constraint which we need to satisfy while designing a database. Then the main tool of designing a relation, that is ER diagram. Then some design issue we will be discussing, weak entity set, extended ER feature and so on. All these concepts we are going to discuss in today's lecture. So starting with the constraint. So what is constraint? Constraint is basically some condition which we need to satisfy from the database. Okay, mapping cardinality constraints. It expresses the number of entity to which another entity can be associated via a relationship set. Okay, we are saying that in a relationship there may involve one or more than one relationship. If only one entity is involved in a relationship, it is called as unary. If exact two entities are involved in a relationship, it is called as binary relationship. And if there are three entities involved in a relationship, it is called as ternary relationship. Okay, so now it expresses the number of entity to which another entity can be associated via a relationship set, is called as mapping cardinality, right? Now it is most useful in describing binary relationship set. Okay, for binary, these cardinality constraint are very very important. Now for a binary relationship set, the mapping cardinality must be one of the following type. It can be 1 to 1, it can be 1 to many, it can be many to one, or it can be many to many. So starting with 1 to 1 mapping cardinality, as the name implies, in 1 to 1, in the first entity set, there are mapping with one in unidirectional or 1 to 1 manner with the second entity set values, right? So if you see in this diagram, A is first entity set and B is second entity set. Suppose in first entity, there are various entities like A1, A2, A3, A4, these all are the tuples, and in entity set B, B1, B2, B3, B4, all are the tuples. Suppose in entity set A, there are 4 entities, and so there should be in B also 4 entities. And the relationship between these entities will be A1 related to B1, A2 related to B2, A3 related to B3, and A4 in relation with the B4. It means the relationship is in 1-to-1 manner. Means for every entity in A, is singly in relationship with the uniquely in relationship with the other and every entity in the entity set B, right? So it is called as 1-to-1 relationship set or 1-to-1 mapping cardinality. Next is 1-to-many. As the name implies, 1-to-many means from entity set A, there may be some entities which are associated with more than one entity in B. Suppose here in this example, in entity set A, there are 3 entities A1, A2, A3. In entity set B, there are B1, B2, B3, B4 and B5. 5 entities are there. So here if you see, A one entity is associated with more than one entity in entity set B. A one is associated with B one as well as B two. It means it is one to many type of cardinalities, right? So some element in A and B may not be mapped to any element in other set. This is very very important. Means in A there may be some element skipped, or in entity set B there may be some element escaped. They are not in relationship with any of the other set, right? This is all about one to one and one to many. Now next, many to one. As the name implies, many means from first entity set there are more than one entity. More than one entity means many entity which are in relationship with the single entity of entity set B, another entity set. Suppose in this example, in entity set A there are five entity A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5. In entity set B there are three entity B1, B2 and B3, right? Now see, many to one means A1 and A2, these are two entity, many entity which are directly linked to only one entity in entity set B, that is B1. So A1 and A2 are related to B1 only. A3 one to one with the B2. Similarly, A4 and A5 are satisfying the condition many to one, because A4 and A5 entity which are related to entity set A are in relationship with the B3 entity of relationship or of entity set B. So this is many to one type of mapping cardinality. Next is many to one, many to many. Many to many is combination of one to many and many to one. In one to many, from entity set A, one entity is in relationship with more than one entity in relationship B. Similarly, in many to one, more than one entity in entity set A are in relationship with the single entity in the relationship B, set B or entity set B. The combination of both one to many and many to one comes under many to many category. Means more than one entity in entity set A can be linked with one entity of B, and more than one entity of entity set B can be linked with one entity in entity set A, right? So some element in A and B may not be mapped to any elements in the other set. This can be the possibility, right? Next, keys. So first, in order to understand the key, you should know the attribute. So attribute is the property of any entity, okay? And what is key? Key are the single attribute or set of attribute based on which we can distinguish among two record or two tuples of any relations, okay? So first, the key is super key. A super key of an entity set is a set of one or more attribute whose values uniquely determine each entity. Now in super key, one very important feature is there, it can contain extraneous attribute. Extraneous attribute means, I am taking example, suppose I have the relation customer. In this customer relation there are three attribute. First attribute is customer ID, second is customer name, and third is customer address, right? So now see, I am saying that customer ID is the key because it is unique, and based on customer ID we can distinguish among the details of two customer, right? Now if with customer ID, if I am adding customer name, then customer ID and customer name in combination can be a super key. Now here customer name is not required to add in the key, but if we are adding still, then customer name is called as extraneous attribute. And customer ID is also super key. Customer ID plus customer name also super key. Customer ID, customer name and customer address also super key. Okay, so super key can have either zero extraneous attribute or it can contain some extraneous attribute, right? Next is candidate key. Minimal super key is called as candidate key. In super key, if we remove the extraneous attribute, then it can become the candidate key. So a candidate key of an entity set is a minimal super key. Suppose customer ID is a candidate key of customer and account number is a candidate key of account relation, right? Although several candidate keys may exist, one of the candidate key is selected to be the primary key. The minimal candidate key is picked as a primary key. Next, keys for relationship set. Suppose I am saying that from customer relation we are picking customer ID, from account relation we are picking account number. Now the combination of primary keys of the participating entity set forms a super key for the relationship set. Suppose customer ID and account number is the super key of the depositor relation. Now depositor is not a entity, it is a relationship set, right? Because depositor comprises two entities. First is customer and second is account. Note, this means a pair of entity set can have at most one relationship in a particular relationship set. Example, if we wish to track all the excess debt to each account by each customer, we cannot assume a relationship for each access. We can use a multi-valued attribute though. Now we must consider the mapping cardinality of the relationship set when deciding what are the candidate keys. Now we need to consider semantics of relationship set in selecting the primary key in case of more than one candidate key, right? Next, ER diagram, very, very important feature. Now in ER diagram, we used to use various type of symbol for different purpose. So first symbol is rectangle. Rectangle represent entity sets. Next is diamond. Diamond represent relationship set. Lines link attribute to entity set and entity set to relationship set. Okay, lines are used as a link. Next is very important, ellipse. Ellipse represent attribute. Double ellipse represent multi-valued attribute, and dashed ellipse denote derived attribute. We discussed about various type of attribute like simple attribute, which comprise only a simple values. Next was composite attribute, in which it is combination of some sub attribute like first name and last name. So name is the composite attribute. Next we discussed about weak or multi-valued attribute like phone number. In phone number there may be more than one entry corresponding to a single customer or single person. Then we discussed about derived attribute, that is age. Age is derived from date of birth. Okay. Now underline indicate primary key attribute. Okay, and primary key we will understand later. So if you see here, customer is written in rectangle, it means customer is a entity set, second entity set is loan. Now in between the diamond, so diamond is relationship and relationship name is here is borrower. Now ellipse represent the attribute. So customer entity is having attribute customer ID, and if you see it is underlined, it means it is primary key. Next is customer name, another attribute, known key attribute, customer city, customer street. Okay, similarly for loan number and loan relation, loan number is the primary key because it is underlined, and next is amount or balance, it is a known key attribute, right? So in this manner we can draw a ER diagram corresponding to different entity and relationship set. Next, ER diagram with some composite attribute. If you see the relation or entity name is customer, here the entity name is customer, and customer is having customer ID underlined, it means it is a primary key attribute. Next is name attribute, but name is further divided in some part, first name, middle name and last name. So it is a composite attribute. It is a composite attribute, right? Next is address. Address is also composite attribute because it contains city, state and zip code sub attribute. Now address contain one sub attribute street, which is further contains some sub attribute like in street. So street is also a composite attribute, and which was the sub attribute of address. So address is composite attribute having four part: street, city, state, and zip code. Street is further classified in street number, street name, and apartment number. So street is also a composite attribute. Next is customer is having phone number, which is written under double ellipse. It means it is a multi-valued attribute. Next is date of birth, normal attribute. And if you see, age is written in dashed attribute or dashed ellipse. It means it is a derived attribute, because it is derived from date of birth attribute. Clear? Next is relationship set. If you see depositor, there are two relationship between customer and account. And customer is having customer ID primary key, customer name, customer city, and customer street. These are non-key attribute. Similarly, account is having account number primary key, and balance is non-key attribute. And depositor is also having some attribute, that is access date. So that's all from this lecture. In next lecture, we will be discussing some new exciting concept about the database design and various modeling concept about the DBMS. Thank you.